Hello, my name is Ashley Simone, and I am documenting my progress in producing a fashion show between me and two other designers. Our fashion show will be happening in the spring of 2015, specifically in the month of April. We recently obtained our location, which is going to be at the Confetti Event Center in Towson. It was actually the first place and the only place that I actually went to go see, but I was just floored with how great it looked, because it had everything, well, has everything that we need, and also the price was pretty much right. I mean, we were talking with other nightclubs to try to see if we could do our fashion show there. There was an art gallery, and there was even a boat. Like one of those cruise boats that you can have dinner on and stuff like that, but they wanted like roughly around $5,000, and this is just to use the location and, you know, to have lights. I don't know if security was involved with that, but there was, you'd have to pay extra in order to have, you know, drinks and food and all that. So Confetti Event Center, yeah, it's meeting all of our needs, and we're still in the planning phases of, okay, how are we going to decorate? Are we going to have refreshments? I would like for us to have light refreshments. We also have to figure out, you know, how we're going to have the models walk. We have to figure out, are we all going to have similar hairstyles for our models? Because some of the designers are using the same models, which means we would also probably have to have a similar makeup. Or if there's going to be a makeup change, like I plan on using a smoky eye for my models, but if there's another designer that wants to have color that really pops out, then it would be easier to do the smoky eye and then just have them, I guess, do the makeup remover, and then do, like, if it's like a neon color, it's easier to do a neon over top. But then if you try to go the other way around, or at least this is what it was explained to me. I might be completely wrong on this. I'm not a makeup artist. That's why we need to hire makeup artists. So if you're in the Baltimore area and you're a hairstylist and or makeup artist, we will be having a casting call for that. We're trying to find people who are interested in doing it for time for print. Now, I do understand that being a hairstylist and a makeup artist, that you guys are using products to, you know, paint faces and do hair. So I'm actually going to talk with the other designers about, like, trying to at least reimburse the hairstylists and makeup artists. As of right now, the models and the photographers have all agreed to do time for print, which is really great, because all of this is coming out of our own pocket. We are going to be trying to sell tickets to the fashion show, but for the price that we'll be selling them at, we're not even going to break even, and it doesn't really make sense to try to sell tickets at a price where we would break even or even really make a profit, because at that point then we might be having to sell tickets for $30, and I don't see anyone buying tickets for $30 to a fashion show, and then after the fashion show is basically going to be like a meet and greet mixer kind of thing where everyone can network, like other photographers, models. I want to try to see if I can get some talent scouts out, you know, just so that, like I said, people can network. And I also want to reach out to other designers and invite them to come see our work, and also like local, you know, fashion boutiques and stuff like that. So it's a lot of planning. So far we've gotten a lot of stuff done. We had our first casting call. We're going to have another one tomorrow. And so all three designers are going to be there for that one. Because the first one, Emma, she couldn't make it, but that was because she was working. And at the time, she thought that she had everything, everyone that she wanted to use, because originally she was just going to do all menswear. But recently she's decided that she wanted to do some women's wear as well. And like all I really know is that at first it was supposed to just be all outerwear, and now it sounds like she's going to do outerwear along with, you know, regular wear. I don't want to give too much away. I mean, I don't know a whole lot, but I don't want to end up spoiling everything. I'm still working out my designs. I have most of them done, but we still have like 5 more months. Now, I'm going to start producing these garments as soon as possible, mainly because when you are creating a design and you're not sure, like, well, what's the right type of fabric I should be using? Because I have one design where I originally thought of using silk, but then for this dress, I wanted to use silk, definitely for the top part. But then for the bottom part, it's layered and it's kind of poofy. So I don't know if I want to use a chiffon, use tulle, or use silk, use all those materials. Yeah, I'm not sure. So I'm going to experiment, which means I'm going to be probably making this dress a couple of times before I can really figure out what's going to be the best option, what's going to look right, what's going to fit well. So there's that. I already have my fabrics, so it's just sitting down and actually cutting everything out, making my flat patterns. I don't know if any buyers would actually show up to our fashion show. That would be pretty awesome. But it's going to be kind of really small, low key, really. So I don't really see it happen. I see it more as it's going to be a networking event where other people in the area who are, you know, models, designers, photographers, who want to, you know, meet other models, photographers, and designers, you know, this is the chance that they would do that. This would be the chance. So, yeah, and we're still also working out, like, how we're selling tickets. I plan on using Eventbrite. But then one of the other designers asked, well, what if we have people who don't want to purchase online? I was like, well, I guess I can understand it, but then also it's just I'm worried about not being able to keep track of the ticket sales. It concerns me, but I'm developing a plan. So basically, if let's say that a friend of mine wants to buy a ticket, but they don't want to do it online. Well, they give me the money, but then I'll go online and buy it through Eventbrite. And then the said friend would have given me their email address, and then I'll just email their ticket that way. I don't know how much of a solid plan this is, but I'm going to sit down and I'm going to work it out. If we can't do it that way, then we're just going to have to tell them, you're just gonna have to buy it online. So we will see. So I am really looking forward to working with these designers and the models. I had my first runway practice with at least 3 models. One of our models, she couldn't make it. And I want to have runway practice at least twice a month, because some of these girls, they've never walked before. I mean, obviously they've walked, but they've never walked the runway. No one's shown them how. So, and it was definitely like, it wasn't challenging today, but it was fun being the instructor and showing them what I want them to do. And it's just, it was a lot of fun. I don't really know what else to say, because it wasn't frustrating. I mean, it was pretty laid back. And like the moms were sitting there. We only had practice for 1 hour, because I didn't really see the point in trying to extend it for any longer with just three to four models. Once we start getting more models, like we should have about 30 models in total once we've completed all of our casting calls and everything. So I'll probably start doing practices longer, maybe breaking them up like per hour, so many girls at this time, and then the next hour will be the next group of girls. So yeah, it's just it's a lot of work to do, and I also have a full-time job and I'm going to school, so I don't know how I'm doing any of this, but I'm doing it. Thankfully, the semester is coming to an end, and next semester I think I'll probably just do one class as opposed to trying to do two and working full-time. So yeah, there's that, what's going on. And next runway practice, as I haven't gotten confirmation from all the models, but most of the models from today, they've said it was okay for me to go ahead and record runway practice because I want to show our progress. Excuse me. Not just from the designer's perspective, but to show, you know, what the models went through and everything. So, and I really just want this to be a learning experience for everyone. So this will not only be an experience for me to put on my resume, but, you know, I'll know what to do ahead of time in the future. Like today, I was telling the girls that we're actually having a second casting call tomorrow, and one of the moms, like she wasn't upset. I mean, she was concerned because her daughter is walking in two of the designers' shows. So there's a mine. She'll be walking for my line and for another designer. But the third designer was already supposed to have her models and then recently decided, well, I want to come to the casting call, see if there's anyone else I might pick. And it was kind of last minute. But to be honest, this thought didn't really cross my mind to notify the models who have already walked for us. And, you know, it should have. Because, like, after I had mentioned it to them, you know, they were pretty disappointed to hear that, well, now, because they didn't get notification of the second casting call, now they can't walk for the third designer. They didn't get to see them. So I'm definitely taking that and learning from that. So next time when there's, like, if we end up doing a third casting call, I'm letting everyone know. So, I definitely, you know, apologize to the models, you know, who already walked for me and the other designer. And, you know, I'm going to talk to the other designers about having alternates because you never know what's going to happen the day of the show. People just either don't show up, there are family emergencies. We did have models sign a contract, but like I said, stuff happens, and, you know, you just kind of just gotta go with it. I mean, there was my very first fashion show. I made 7 garments, but I could only show 6 of them because last minute my model pulled out. Well, technically the parent pulled the model out. I did a mix of children's wear up to women's wear, and my parents made a recording of it. But we can't figure out how to get it off of the camcorder and onto the computer. So I have a new computer, so I might try to fiddle with that because I really would love to show that to everyone because it was my very first fashion show and everything looked gorgeous. So hopefully I'll be posting that soon. This video is a lot longer than I thought it was going to be, and I'm sorry if this was boring or crappy, but I've never really done this before, so thank you for watching, and I'm hoping to show you guys more stuff very soon. So, bye!